Draining the radiator on this Volvo S60 V70, all the range XC90 from 2001 to 9 or more. This is the radiator valve. This is the drain valve. I just have a spare one. It looks like this. You need to be careful because this guy is made of plastic, and some people may have before you may have tightened this too much and it may just break. So it's a good idea to get a spare one. I'm sure Volvo surely sells it, but I got it from junkyard. It has a small rubber seal here, and the idea is that basically you don't need to tighten it with the wrench. What I usually do, I just screw it. I use the wrench just to help me screw it a little bit, and when it stops I will just give it a small kick. Or even you don't need that, it stays in there because it will never unscrew because of this gasket. Anyhow, let's just go for it. Always recycle the liquid. I bring it to a hardware store nearby. So we need to see, this is the front bumper, and we are going to find a hole right there. And if you look inside, perhaps with a flashlight, you'll notice this little guy. It takes, be sure to get the right size T40, because otherwise you'll just rip that plastic star or torx hole. It gets perfectly fit in there, but if you have a T30, let's say you use a T30, you are going to strip it, and simply you perhaps need an extension. 3-inch extension should be plenty enough. I think I didn't really tighten my. Be sure to match properly, because it's really by feeling to match the torx until it goes all the way in there. You notice how it's disappearing, and it should be sitting fully in there. Maybe press a little bit. Be sure to undo it the right way. You notice mine wasn't really tight. I just do it by hand, and it will never leak, because it's actually, it's impossible for it to untighten, to unscrew, just because of that rubber seal. And my suggestion, when you see it's turning, remove, if you use a ratchet, remove it so you don't get it wet. It's always good to have a glove, but hey, always do this on cold engine. And basically you can leave it half open like this without removing it, but I prefer to remove it, basically because it will just drain it faster. It's not a problem. Again, this is how it looks. Again, that's a seal here, a small rubber gasket. It takes a few minutes, and when I'm finished, I'll just, by the way, this is water, because I'm rinsing the system with distilled water. Always never put tap water, your garden hose. Just, I just want to put this guy back in place. Maybe it's not very easy to see. Just for my peace of mind, I will just give it a small, small kick here. Just that. I had a big problem with perhaps some deposit inside my cooling system, and if this cooling system, in the box it says it takes 7 or 7.5 liters. Perhaps you'll be surprised, sometimes you cannot squeeze not even 5 liters back in there. And my explanation for this is that you may have a stuck passage, clogged passage inside the cooling system, and that's caused by limestone deposits. Perhaps someone in the past used garden hose or just tap water to mix with coolant. And yeah, I had a big problem with that. The engine is not overheating, but anyhow, I'm not going to give details, because I don't want people to think I'm saying stupid things. But I managed to get rid of that, and I managed to really clean my system with that Preston flush. However, and this is entirely up to you, I did not use one bottle. I did use actually almost 3 bottles, and I did run them for 2 months in the summertime, obviously. And when I did that, that's why I'm flushing. I'm really flushing a lot of times with distilled water. When I finished that, my cabin heat got much better than before. And then when I did flush with the, those bottles of Preston, when I refill it with distilled water, because I'm rinsing, when I refill it, I could squeeze almost 6 liters and a half